I've made a copy of ODB 53, and I'm calling this one ODB 54, View by Department, Part 2. I'm going to make a copy of the form we started in the previous video by right-clicking, copy, then I'm going to right-click, paste, and I'm going to call this one ODB 54, View by Department, Part 2. Now we'll edit this form by right-clicking and selecting Edit. I'm going to open up the Form Navigator by clicking on the Form Navigator button down here at the bottom. I'm going to come up to Forms and right-click on that. Then under New, select New Form. This is going to be our subform, so I'm going to right-click on this and come down to Properties. I'm just going to change the name to Subform so we remember that this is our subform. Then coming over to the data, I want to add a table in as the content type. And then for the content, we want this to be the employees table. We don't need the filter or sort, but under the link fields, I'm going to click on the dialog button. And here's our table filter. We want to select the department ID, and we want to match that up to our department ID on our employee table. And click OK. We can close this. Now that we've got our table hooked up to our subform, we need to add some fields. I'm clicking on this just to make sure that we all see that the subform is selected. Then I'm going to come down to our controls toolbar and click on the more controls. And I also want to make sure that my wizards is turned on, so I'll click on that. Now I'll come over to the table controls, select that, and draw an outline of where I want my table controls. And because we turned on the wizards, our dialog box pops up asking us what fields do we want on our table controls. I want the employee ID, last name, first name, start date, and then we'll skip down to department ID and group ID and click finish. I'm going to close our form navigator and let's see how this looks in design view. So I'll come down to design view and click that. We see that we're missing a few of the fields. Let's go back, make this a little larger, and back into design view. So marketing is department 5. Let's change the department to, let's make it IT. I'll click the save. Then we need to click the refresh. And it shows us all the department IDs of 2, which is IT. Now this works pretty well, but I would rather just click a button. Instead of save, let's change this to refresh. So I'll go back into edit, right click, controls, back into action, and we'll change that to refresh form. Let's go up to the top and change our button save to button refresh and change our label from save to refresh. And close that. Let's try it again. Back into design view. I'm coming up to our department. I will change that to accounting, click refresh. Now we get a pop-up that says, do we want to save the changes in our form? I'll type yes, and it shows us the accounting or department 1. Back into management, refresh, and we get this pop-up again. To get rid of the pop-up, we'll go back into Edit. We need to open up our Form Navigator again. And I'm going to change our button. Right now, it's on our form. I want to add it to our subform. So I'm just going to grab it and drag and drop it onto the subform. And now we see that our refresh button is under the subform instead of under the form. Going back into Design View. Now when I change this to IT, click Refresh, we see all Department 2. Go into Marketing, Refresh. So our button's working the way we want. We have one more problem. Our department IDs don't really tell us what department we're in, as well as the group. We want that to show the department name and the group name. Let's go back into Edit. I'm going to come up to the department ID in our subform, right-click on department ID, and I want to replace with, and I'm going to change our number box to a list box. I'm going to do the same thing for group ID, replace with list box. Now I'm going to click on the department ID and also open up the properties controls. So this is still showing that our button refresh. I want to click again on department ID. I'm going to change this to department, taking off the ID. And we can change the name here to LST department. Going over into data, we want the data field to be department ID. The type of list, we're going to change this to SQL. Click on the list content. And we've gone over this in the previous videos, so this should be nothing new. Department, add, close. We want the department name, and then the department ID. And we want this in this order, so the department name shows up in the list box, and the department ID is linked to the bound field. I'll run it. Runs OK. Click Save. And close this window. Let's do the same thing with group ID. Go back to general. Change this to group. Change this to LSTGRP. Now in the data tab, we have our data field is group ID. We want to change our list contents to SQL. Click on the dialog box. Make this the group table, add, we want group name, then group ID. We'll run it just to make sure it runs. Click Save, close, close, and let's go into Design View and see how this looks. So now we have our department names in there. When I change the value in our department up here, management, refresh. We see management, IT, refresh, there's IT. We may want to center these, but when I click into the department fields, we see that we've got a drop down, so I can actually change this. I don't want that to happen. I want this to be a view. So I'll go back into edit mode, click on my form navigation. Right click on the subform and on the properties. I'm going into the data tab and then I'm going to change the allow additions to no, allow modifications to no, and allow deletions to no. Let's close this. Close this. Go back into design view. Now when I click on here, it's just a view screen. So I can view my employees by department, and it is only a view screen. I'm going to save this form, close it, and save the database.